Fast car, fast car, zoom, zoom, zoom. You need to hear this if you're a fan of spine-chilling encounters out of the classic book of short stories I wrote and published called Crime Artist. Check the link in my bio for more details. A day at Burger King turned into a nightmare.
The young woman screamed at her six-year-old son, jerking his hand, screamed at her six-year-old son, jerking his hand in the long line.
A huge man with cowboy boots, a leather jacket, and a disfigured face resembling burned plastic loomed closer. The dining room watched in silence.
Enough!
The woman shouted, dragging her child into the restroom. She set Keith on the sink countertop, trying to calm him. They could hear the old man's footsteps echoing in the hall. The tension was palpable.
Watching with a serious stare, the man began to explain.
But the woman cut him off. No, you're in no condition to race,
Lorraine says to her boyfriend, Reezy.
Why, that was all he could think of. Tuesday, when his agent Charles called.
Says he wanted to book Rezzy for the finals out in Northbrook.
There was no way she was going to let him race. Not after last month's accident, even if it was that race that gave him the title.
Yeah, Reezy won within inches of his life, earned notoriety, a bronze cup, a $500,000 trophy car for the statue.
A 1979 Monte Carlo, cantaloupe cream, plush leather seats, pussy pink interior, black velvet foot rugs, charcoal black Firestone tires, sealed against chrome bleach white rims, dual exhaust, the works. Reezy thought about not entering the race as he tapped the hood of his new car. Sinking his head between his arms, he thought about racing until the hospital stay came to mind, the accident.
Remember how long you had to wear that clumsy back brace? The treatment? How many times your uncle came out to see you?
All Reezy could think of was winning the race.
No, I couldn't let her words get to me. I have to stay focused. Don't let anything persuade you. Look how far I got. $500,000, a 350 Monte Carlo, my favorite. I could invest the money, put my car in the freezer, figuratively speaking, putting the car in storage as a collector's item. I was nervous, though. I never raced this stretch of highway before. It was a dangerous feat. On top of a cliff about 8 miles high, covered in rocky grit. So there's a pothole turning into the curb that would jolt the car off course, out of position, leap over the guardrail, cause a fatal accident if you weren't accurate. If you lose control, it's over.
What happened next? Imagine. Brought to you by Rodney's Publishing. Don't forget to watch my entire playlist, Rodney's Writing Den, Rodney's Book Club. And if you like anime voiceover, Rodney's Film Club. It's a very intense and provocative piece. The narrative scenes are very disturbing. Leave your comments, likes, and dislikes. I want to know what you think.